I'm going to talk about internal control reporting and audit reporting lag and the further evidence. What is this paper really about? It's about the association between the internal control and audit reporting after the implementation of Sarbanes-Oxley in 2002. Basically, there was another paper, Eldridge et al., which described about the association to an extent of 3 years, till 2005. And then, as an extension to that paper, this research paper has been written so that they can capture the implications of implementation of SOX on the internal controls and audit reporting lags. And how is this paper really structured? It uses historical data and data from 2007 and 2008, and it analyzes how the reporting lags have been for various firms. How they have trended, like if they have increased or decreased, and they also compare the two different type of filers, like accelerated filers, the companies which have like more than 75 million, and then non-accelerated filers, which are really small companies, and how the reporting lag for these companies trend over time, that has been discussed, and also they examine the process of remediation for various firms. That means like if figure a material weakness in a firm and in 2008, and then if that material weakness continues to exist in 2009, what is the audit lag? And if a firm, some firms, if it is remediated, then what is the audit lag? How is it trending? And after that, conclusions we'll talk about later. So why was this done again? So reporting, audit reporting is one of the crucial things that we usually have in, to determine the health of the company, and also to determine the market value of the company. And it also is very important in terms of, it signifies the, the higher degree of information asynchronism that usually tampers the health of the company if it is too much. And then, one of the reasons for this is the section 409 SOX authorizes the SEC to require registrars to disclose the public on a rapid and current basis. So all the accounting information and the financial information for each firm needs to be disclosed on a rapid basis. Like for a large accelerated filers, it's 60 days, and for accelerated filers, 75 days, and non-accelerated filers, 90 days. So keeping this timeline in mind, how the audit reporting lags might affect the company's reporting is what is basically analyzed in this paper. And obviously this is an extension for ELO study for the fifth and sixth years.
I always argue that 409 really was saying you need real-time reporting, but that's what they basically interpreted 409 as saying, just make it a little bit faster, instead of being 90 days, require reports to come out in 45 days or 60 days or whatever. And I even wrote in papers that 409 would require for research on continuous reporting. And of course, no one paid any attention to it.
So there are basically three main research questions that the authors try to answer. The first one is, how is audit report lag associated with a material weakness in internal controls in the fifth and sixth year after the implementation of section 404? And the second one is, how does the lag associated with the weakness for a shorter duration, like for non-accelerated filers than accelerated filers. So they use this regression equation, which has the independent variable as the audit lag, and there are various independent variables which kind of define each firm that has been considered. the main significant variables that contribute to the output are material weakness, internal control, size, geo concern, and audit CH. So the data sample that they have taken is the audit data, audit analytics data from information section 404 reporting, and they have also taken the CompuStrat database, which is basically the main data set that they are going to analyze. And they have ignored firms, foreign firms and firms in the financial sector, and they have also ignored duplicate entries. And they have taken firms which have fiscal year ending from 15th of December 2007 to 28th of February. That is because SOX 404A became applicable for the companies after December 15. So they want to analyze that aspect of the company. So that is the duration that they chose for the companies in the data set. And they remove the observations with missing financial audit fee data. So this is basically described in the earlier slide, how the foreign companies are removed from the data set, and how duplicate companies are removed, and companies with fiscal year other than between December 15 and 29th of February are not considered in the data set. So this is another descriptive data that we have here. Sorry. So the proportion of isolated filers with an adverse section of 404 reports is much lower than that reported in either ELS or other studies that have been used data for the initial years of section 404 reporting. And we can also see that the proportion for companies with an adverse 404 reporting is higher for non-isolated filers than the isolated filers. And it's also given an adverse internal control report, it is much more likely to be entity level than accounting level. So the results here, they show that the mean audit lag is higher for firms with material weakness as compared to firms without material weakness for both isolated and non-isolated. And material weakness is it's kind of a deficiency in the internal control, which may result in misstatements of financial statements. So that could be a cause for the delay in the audit reporting. And the mean audit reporting delay is relevant as the year progresses. As and when the years keep increasing, companies are identifying material weaknesses and they're trying to rectify them, and hence we can suggest that the delay is being reduced. And this is another result which answers the question 1 and 2 based on the regression. Small firms with poor financial conditions measured by loss and goes on have larger lags as compared to large firms. And firms with initial year of audit engagements have higher lags. We can see from the highlighted fields there, and also the indices that have been used mentioned in parentheses below. And coefficient of medial weakness internal control is positive and significant for both isolated and non-isolated filers. And firms with medial weakness in internal control reporting have longer lags than compared to those without material weakness. That is kind of evident because of the deficiency in the process. And material weakness coefficient explains the degree of audit involvement. For isolated filers, the coefficient decreases significantly between 2008 to 2009, showing the auditor learning effects. And for non-isolated filers, the changes is less for no formal intervention of auditors are there. And also because they are not subject to the 404B section. In 2009, the result says that the difference between the coefficients of entity material weakness information, internal control, I'm sorry, and AMWIC are significant as compared to 2008 for isolated filers. And the same difference for non-accelerator fires is not so significant. Overall decline in reporting is due to decline in account level material weakness, internal control for accelerator fires. And we can also see that the impact of having material weakness and internal controls is more in isolated filers than non-isolated filers. And the decline of impact is also more in isolated filers when compared to the non-isolated filers. This is basically due to the effect of 404B section. And the third question is related to the remediation of material weakness, and it has been split into two parts, where they examine the remediation of previously reported material weakness control results in reduction in audit lag. They just want to analyze.
What does remediation mean? Just for everyone.
Pardon?
What does remediation mean?
When they find any material weakness, they try to come up with a solution so that they can mitigate that weakness, and the audit reporting process can be more stabilized in future.
Okay.
And the second question, they try to examine if remediating firms continue to have higher audit reporting lag compared to firms that have clean internal audit. So for this, they have taken different kind of coefficient with a similar data set. They have taken clean 0809 as the coefficient for all the firms which have which do not have any material weakness in them, and they have taken material weakness internal control 0809 as the firms which have material weakness in both the years 2008 and 2009, and the firms which don't have a material weakness in 2009 which have been cleared of them but have them in 2008 are signified with the coefficient material weakness IC08_clean. So basically, the last two coefficients have been chosen to interpret the results of the regression. The coefficient of material weakness IC08, clean 09, should be significantly lower than the first one if the remediation leads to lower audit lag. So basically, what this means is if the coefficient for the if there is a cleansing or of the material weakness, or there is no remediation in the material weakness, then the reporting lag is reduced significantly as the years progress. So the results from this positive and significant coefficients of the clean material weakness, the clean coefficient in the two regression says that remediating firms continue to have higher audit reporting lags compared to the firms, like I just said earlier. And difference in the coefficients for accelerating firms is more when compared to non-accelerating firms. And remediation leads to significant reduction in report lags. The conclusion that the author draws from the observations is, observation and analysis is that the results of 2008 indicate that the effect of having material weakness in internal controls on the audit report is significantly smaller for non-isolated filers than the isolated filers. And also the internal control effect is lower in significantly lower in 2009 than in 2008 for isolated filers. But that is not the case with non-isolated filers. And for the isolated filers, firms that remediate previously disclosed problems have shorter audit report lags than the firms that do not.
I have a question on the first bullet point.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's saying that the lag is significantly smaller, then I guess I'm wondering, are these small firms actually remediating any of these internal control weaknesses? And then to follow with that, I guess, does it even matter if, I guess for a financial statement audit perspective, if the auditors are relying on substantive testing, then maybe it doesn't matter that they're remediating, but to me it just seems like it still might be a problem for firm operations, and I'm not, I don't know. It was just a thought I had. I didn't know if anyone else had any ideas.
I think I can't remember who it is. One, either Yoon or Tiffany was looking at auditor changes. And after the auditor changes in the smaller firms, what has happened, qualifying or not qualifying. And I was very surprised the large number of auditor changes that happened and how many of them got qualified statements. I actually have a more general problem. Is this an interesting research? Actually, why don't we let her make her comments and then we go to my questions here. Okay, thank you.